Hey, welcome to FlipMath.com, section 0.1, Solving Simple Equations. I'm Mr. Kelly. I'm at Kaiser Slaughter High School. This year, you're going to have up to four teachers, depending on what your teacher chooses to do. And first, we're going to learn how to complete a packet. Then we'll get into the lesson, which is solving simple equations. So what we want to go through, when you complete one of our packets, here's the important things. Number one, take the packet out. The first page is notes. Use headphones so all of the other distractions are outside and you can hear the instruction clearly. Okay, put the other distractions away. Get away from your cell phone, your Snapchat, your MySpace, all those other things. Put them away. Okay, and write your questions in the margin. Like, I don't understand. You can put it right here. I don't get how Sully does something. All right, so that goes right here in the margin so that tomorrow or today, when the teacher comes around, whenever you see the teacher next, you can ask those questions. So that's how you take notes. After we take notes, what we're going to do is practice. Now, you can see we have a little part right here that says practice, and that's where you get better at something. All right, so you got to practice and you check it. Now, you check your answers as you go. We give you the answers to the practice because practice is just that. Okay, we're not going to put a grade on it because you're not good at it yet, and you need to practice it. We give you the answer so you can see if you're learning it correctly. Look for your mistakes in the steps. One of the things you're going to notice is when we give you the answers, let me show you that right here, we're going to give you all of the answers with all of the work shown. Look at this. Okay, so add 10. This is the homework that goes with this packet. Now, you could go through. Some students, they cut corners. They want to finish things early. They go with this. They could kind of copy it down, and they don't learn. Well, you're going to learn very quickly that not learning is not the way. It's the longest way through this course, and your grade's going to drop. So you really want to go through and do these problems, and we're going to try our best to show every single step. You can see we have different colors here. Sometimes we do that, sometimes we don't. But we're going to go through, put little hints, make sure you understand it. If you don't understand it, you need to ask someone, either somebody in your class or preferably go to your teacher and ask your teacher. So that's looking for mistakes in your steps and circle problems you don't get. That way they're easy to come back to. There's nothing more frustrating than you come back to a student and I'm like, okay, what'd you do wrong? And they're like, hold on, let me find it. All right, so put a little mark, put a star or circle it. Lastly, the application problems. Okay, the application problems we do not give you the answers to. That's at the very end. Today's are a little different, but these are harder word problems. All right, we're not going to give you the answer though. You need to have some grit. And what grit is, sorry for scrolling so much, but grit is the ability to sit there and actually sustain some effort through the problem, not just quitting and saying, oh, I don't get it because it's hard and I can't do it. Remember that you're going to apply what you've learned, so they all will have something to do with that lesson. That's a little hint. And sometimes you have to think differently. Maybe you got to make a chart or a graph or, you know, some outside thing. So work through it, have some grit, finish that application, but that's how you complete one of our packets. Okay, on to the lesson now. We're reviewing solving equations. And as you know, to solve an equation, okay, an equation is when you have two expressions that are equal to each other. Normally the equal sign will tell you, hey, that's an equation. But to solve it, what we do is we take apart the equation so we can work backwards and find the unknown variable. So to take apart, we kind of undo everything. We're going to apply the inverse operations in reverse order, which means however they built the equation, we're going to take it apart using the opposite operation. So as you know, subtraction is the opposite of addition, and addition is the opposite of subtraction. Multiplication with division and vice versa. Okay, it goes back. So that's what we're going to use to solve these equations. What I sometimes tell students to focus on is to look at how this expression is built. If you were to plug a number into x here, what do you do first? We know our order of operations. You plug a number in here, you have to divide first by 2, and then you would add 3. And the end result would be 19. That's our equation. All right, so what's the opposite of dividing? Multiplying. So you divide by 2, multiplying by 2 will undo that. If you add 3, subtracting 3 will undo that. So what we need to do is, in reverse order of how the equation was built, we need to go through and undo everything so we can solve this equation. Now, what does that look like on paper? Okay, well, normally I tell my students, draw a line down the equal sign. That's very important. You want to keep everything on the left-hand side, on the left-hand side, everything on the right-hand side over there. Now, looking at this little chart right here, the first thing, if you plug a number in for x, the first thing you would do is divide by 2, and the last thing you would do is add 3. So we need to get rid of that add 3 part first before we can go and undo the division. So this is the way the equation was made. You divide by 2, then you add 3. So this is the way you should solve the equation. The first thing we should do is subtract 3. So I'm going to do that, except I'm going to get rid of these extra lines. Who put those there? So add 3. The opposite is subtract. So from each side of the line, that's why the line's important. It keeps it balanced. Each side of the line, we're going to subtract 3. Cross these out because they cancel. Now, we kind of read this like a textbook, like you go left to right. That's how we read, right? So x over 2, and there's nothing down here. So that's going to kind of come down, x over 2. And then we have 3 minus 3. They cancel, so I don't have to worry about anything there. Where the line is the equal sign. And last, we have 19 minus 3. That's going to give us 16. So we have a new equation. X divided by 2 equals 16. All right, now, we already did this, subtract 3, and now we need the next step. For the next step, we need to undo dividing by 2. So how do you get rid of? You have some number, you divide by 2, and it equals 16. So let's multiply both sides by 2. That's the opposite. If you remember, they will cancel. And again, we read this like a textbook. We go left to right. So the 2's cancel, you're left with an X equals, and then 16 times 2 is 32. And right there's our answer. All right, now to check it, I will tell you this now, but we don't make you do it. To check it, just plug it in and check it, you know, figure it out. So 32. 32 divided by 2, 16. 16 plus 3 is 19. So it works. You can put a little check next to it. Good job. Way to go. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to solve how many equations? Ooh, 6. Let's solve 6 equations real quick. And I'm going to use some shorthand over here to help me figure out what to do to solve the equation. Now, I'm going to pretend like I'm plugging a number in here, and you know our order of operations. We call it GEMDAS. Okay, some of you have heard PEMDAS, but let me write it down. So what this means is grouping symbols. Aha, that's parentheses, but sometimes grouping symbols up here, like that. Okay, grouping symbols, exponents, multiply, divide, they're kind of tied. They don't tell you that, do they? And addition and subtraction, they're tied as well. So that tells me the order of operations which we do things, and that's kind of important because you have to know, like, the variable, how it all works out here to get to the 2. It's like a trip. Like, we have a variable, you do stuff to it, and you get to 2. So we need to figure out how to undo everything to work back to where we started. So looking here, if we have f, like f plus 2.5, there is a fraction bar here, which means divided by 3. You have to divide this whole top by 3. So the first thing that's going to happen is you're going to add 2.5. And what I'm doing right now is I'm going to remake this chart down here, but I'm going to use shorthand. So the first thing that you do to the variable, if you were going to plug a number in the variable, you'd add 2.5. The next thing is you would divide by 3. So then, what is the opposite? Okay, what's the opposite of dividing by 3? Multiplying by 3. And the opposite of adding 2.5 is subtracting. So just like in the chart, this is how the equation was built. First you added 2.5, then you divided by 3. This is how we're going to solve the equation. First we're going to do this, and then we're going to do this. So the first thing we need to do, it says right here, is multiply by 3. So line down the equal sign. Multiply by 3. Here we go. Multiply by 3, both sides. These cancel, and we're left with f plus 2.5 equals, that equal goes with the line, 6. And that's that step right there. So the next step, we need to subtract 2.5. So again, we draw a line down the equal sign. We're going to subtract 2.5 from each side of the equation. And we're going to get, let's read it like a book. We go left to right. So f, there is nothing else. 2.5 minus 2.5, they cancel. We have our equal sign, and then 6 minus 2.5. 6 minus 2 is 4. Subtract another 0.5, and we get 3.5. And there's that answer. We're done with that one. Okay, so let's try the next one. I'm going to do the next one. Let's do one more of these with that, and then I'm not going to use that anymore because it should start to become a habit for you. So the first thing I'm going to do, if I'm going to plug a number into R, is the first thing I would do is multiply by 16, and then I would subtract 12. All right, so the opposite of that, the opposite of subtraction is addition, the opposite of multiplication is division. So this is how the equation's built, this is how we solve it. So I need to add 12 to both sides first. Then I need to divide by 16. Draw a line at the equal sign. Let's get started. Add 12. So you have to make sure that when you add 12, each side of the equal sign, we have to keep it balanced. You can't add 12 to the same side and then nothing on the other side. Some students do that. That's an ugly two. So let's read it left to right like a book. 16R. They cancel. Equals negative 4 plus 12. That's 8. Okay, so we did that step right there. The next step is to divide by 16. And a lot of you have seen this because you've done these before. R he will equal 8 over 16, which is 1/2 when I reduce it. Can you write a decimal? Yeah, you can write a decimal, I guess, if you want to, but 1/2 is a cool little fraction. Why wouldn't you want to do that? Let's go on to number 3. Okay, with number 3, what we need to remember is we have these two. Look at that. We have 2j minus 4j. Well, what's 2 minus 4? These are like terms. We can combine those together. Let's solve this equation. Draw a line down the middle. And let's simplify this or combine like terms. 2 minus 4. 2j minus 4j. That's negative 2j. And we have our plus 10. Don't ever try to do too many steps in once. Okay, we're just going to do one step at a time. We get this resulting equation. Now look, this looks like the other ones. What do we have to do? Let's get rid of this 10. This is plus 10. And if you want to write this little thing off to the side that we have there, the little helper thing, you can. But I'm going to stop doing it right now. We're going to add 10 to both sides because that's going to get rid of the plus 10. Oh, I lied. We're going to subtract 10. Whoa, that was close. All right, so working left to right, negative 2j comes down. Negative 2j. 10 minus 10, they canceled. The equal sign is at the line. And 12 minus 10, that's 2. So now we have a resulting equation that's equivalent to the one before it, but it's easier to solve because we have negative 2j equals 2. So this is multiply. The opposite is divide. So divide both sides by negative 2. And again, these will cancel. We get, working left to right, j equal sign and then a negative 1. And that is our final answer. I'm going to ask you again, how do you check that? Plug it back in here. Figure it all out. See if the left-hand side equals 12 like it should. Hopefully it does. Check it. We're going to move on to number 4. All right, so the only difference between 4 and the ones we've done before is that the variable's on the right. So I'm going to put the variable on the right a lot. Why not? It can be on the left. It can be on the right. Draw a line down the equal sign. Add 10 to each side. Right? Okay, so the x is with the 1/3. We've got to get rid of the minus 10. The opposite of minus 10 is add 10. So now let's read this like a book, left to right. We have 5 plus 10, that's 15. We have the equal sign. We have 1/3 x, and we have negative 10 plus 10. They cancel. So now we have negative, or we don't have negative, we have 15 equals 1/3 x. How are we going to get rid of this? Well, one of these little tricks I'm going to show you here. If you have a fraction in front of a variable, one way to get rid of it is to multiply by the reciprocal. So I'm going to flip that 1/3 on both sides. Now, what is that going to do? Let's take a look. If I flip that 1/3 and get 3 over 1, on the right-hand side, we have 1 times 3, 3 times 1. These cancel each other. 1/3 times 3 is just 1. They cancel. They undo each other. So cancel, cancel. We're left with just an x. And on the left-hand side, we get 45 because it's 3 times 15, and we're all done. That's one way to do it. Can I back this up? Back it up. Back it up to right about here. Another way to do it, if you wanted to, is you could divide both sides by 1/3. Now, the only problem with this is it's messy. When you put it in the calculator, you got to make sure you're doing 15 divided by 1/3. Let me show you that. This is how you put a fraction in the calculator. You have to use parentheses. It's 15 divided by 1/3. So make sure you put the parentheses, because if you don't, you could get the wrong answer. All right, but when we do that, we get 45, just like the other time we did it. So how are we gonna, how are we gonna show all this? We have to be clear on how we're showing. So 15 divided by 1/3. See how I used parentheses so it was clear? 15 divided by 1/3 was 45, and that all equals 1/3 divided by 1/3. They cancel, and I get x. Done with that one. Okay, two more. One more trick I want to show you. 12 divided by negative d over 5. So what I'm going to do is show you a fraction over here. Let's call it negative 12 over 4. And for, oops, I don't want to do the 4. Sorry, forgot what I was doing. 12 over negative 4. What does this equal? Negative 3. What does this equal? Negative 3. So the point I'm trying to make is, it doesn't matter where the negative goes. What if you had it in front, like this, negative 12 over 4? That's also negative 3. So the rule is, you have a negative, it can go anywhere, really. It can go on the top, it can go on the bottom, it can go out front. But you can only have one negative, you can't make it two. So in this problem, to make our life easier, I'm going to rewrite it as 12 equals d over negative 5. And now it becomes really easy, because d divided by negative 5. What's the opposite of dividing by negative 5? Well, multiplying by negative 5. So we're going to multiply both sides by negative 5. That's how I show it. I can show it in parentheses. Negative 5 times 12 is negative 60. And on the right-hand side, these cancel, and I get d. All right, so that's the easy way. If you have a negative just floating around, put it in the bottom. Put it without the variable. Wherever the variable is, put it in the other place. All right, last point right here. Then you can try some. So we have 1/5 equals 3 minus x. Oh, my goodness. So to solve this problem, I'm going to draw my line down. I'm going to get rid of the 3. Let's get rid of the 3. 1/5 minus 3. So here's how you do that in the calculator. Notice how I have 1/5 minus 3. And it says negative 2.8. Let me show you a little trick right now. Hit the math button and then hit enter. See how it says turn it into a fraction? I hit enter right here. Boom. Negative 14/5. That's the improper fraction. And I'm going to use that. Woo. Negative 14/5. And all of that equals, so 1/5 minus 3 is negative 14/5. That equals, they cancel. And remember the trick I just taught you? If there's a negative in front of a fraction, let's just put it with a number in the bottom. It's going to make your life easier. X over negative 3. All right, now, how do I solve this equation? It's x divided by negative 3. I know there's fractions. I know it looks ugly, but it's the same. You just do the same thing, same numbers. If you want to divide by negative 3, you want to undo that, we're just going to multiply both sides by negative 3. Negative 3. So here's what we need to do in the calculator. Let's bring that up. Okay, let's see how I wrote that out here. It's negative 3. Here's what we want to do. Negative 3 times negative 14/5. Negative 3 times, use your parentheses, negative 14/5. When I get that answer, I get 8.4. But I am loving the fractions, so I'm going to hit math. And then the first choice is put it into a fraction, and I get 42/5. So down here, yeah, I'm going to give you an answer of negative 42/5. And that's okay, because we got to get used to fractions. They're going to cancel out, and I get x. Booyah. All right, so now it's your turn to try things. I put some fractions in here and some combined like terms. Pause the video. When we say pause it, pause the video and try these two all by yourself. Go. All right, so here's how I got the first one done. Okay, so x minus 4, and then you divide by 8. We got to get rid of that divided by 8 first. So we multiply both sides by 8, because that's the opposite of divide by 8. So working left to right, 8 times a half. That's a half of 8. That's easy. 4. Equal sign. And then these 8s cancel. So you're left with x minus 4 equals 4. I'm then going to add 4 to each side. And that'll give me 8 equals x on that problem. All right, next problem. What do you got? 1. And then these go together. It's like negative 4 minus 9. That's negative 13. Don't forget the y. And that equals 14. So at this point, we have a regular equation, two-step. Draw the line down the middle. We're going to subtract 1 from each side. We get, all right, how do we do this? 1 minus 1 is 0, so they kind of cancel. We get a negative. Don't forget the negative. Negative 13y equals 14 minus 1, which is 13. Now, it's negative 13 times y, so we divide by negative 13. Don't forget the negative. So then we read it like a book again. Negative 13y divided by negative 13. They cancel. We get y equals 13 divided by negative 13 is a negative 1. And again, I'm going to tell you, the way you can check your answer, if you want to plug, like, let's plug this 8 into the answer here to see if it's right. So 8 minus 4 is 4. 4 divided by 8, that's 1/2. That works out. In this example, we're going to get 1 minus negative 4, that's 5, minus negative 9. So 5 minus negative 9 is 14. That one works too. So they both work when you check it in. You can always do that. So that's it. That's the end of your first video. Go ahead. Good luck with this. Make sure you check your answers. You have some application questions that are really about our packets and stuff. Good luck to you. This is Mr. Kelly in Kaiserslautern. Remember, it's nice to be important. More important to be nice. See you.